I wonder, why do scientists study poop? Oh, hi, I'm Kaden. Welcome to Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute, where I've been wondering, why do scientists collect and study poop? Let's go explore the zoo and find out. Come on. So what do you think? Why do scientists study poop? Poop or scat can tell us many different things. It can tell us what animals are in the area, what kinds of food they eat, how healthy they are, and so much more. Scientists can make observations based on its color, contents, shape, and size. They can tell us what an animal eats or if it's an herbivore, carnivore, or omnivore. And you can even start to identify the animal it belongs to based on the shape and contents of the scat. Deer and other herbivores have brown pellet-shaped scat, while tigers and other carnivores leave behind tube-shaped scat that often contains fur. Poop also contains traces of DNA, hormones, diseases, and nutrients that can help us learn about an animal's diet, health, habitat, and even our ecosystem. Since everyone poops, it's an easy method to study an animal without getting too close to them. But how do we collect poop? And how do we keep track of whose poop is whose? Let's go take a look at a few animals and get the scoop on poop. Collecting and studying poop can give scientists a closer look at an animal's health. So we often study poop here at the zoo to make sure our animals are healthy. But how do we study individuals in our social animal groups where more than one animal lives together? I'll give you a hint. Think about topping your favorite food with sparkles instead of sprinkles. If multiple animals' poops are being collected, each animal gets assigned a colorful glitter to help identify their poop. Before being fed, each animal gets assigned a color, and then a non-toxic food-safe glitter is sprinkled on top of their food. The next morning, zookeepers are on the lookout for colorful poop. Each sample is then collected, bagged individually, labeled, and put in a freezer before being sent to our scientists and our nutrition, genomics, or endocrinology labs. Once in the lab, poop is ready to be analyzed and recorded, like this elephant poop. One important piece of information poop can tell us is hormone levels. Hormones in poop and urine can help us better understand a normal reproductive cycle, or when an animal is ready to breed. This work has been used to breed some of the most endangered species, like whooping cranes, giant pandas, and black-footed ferrets. Now, what about animals in the wild? How does collecting poop from animals in zoos help wild animals? Let's go find out by visiting an animal whose poop contains a lot of bones and scales and smells a lot like fish. What animal do you think we're gonna see? Did you guess the North American river otter? River otters are semi-aquatic, so they spend a lot of time exploring both in the water and on land. Besides playing, there's one thing they love doing on land, and that's pooping. They come on land to poop in the same place over and over and over again, and we call those areas latrines. You can find them on docks, walkways, and in the marsh grasses around where they live. Scientists noticed these latrines and wanted to learn more, so they placed hidden cameras all around them. These cameras have motion sensors that start the camera whenever there's movement, so they can record the behavior of the animals in the area. By setting up cameras to watch otters and their latrines, scientists are able to learn more about otters' social lives and their favorite snacks like fish and crabs. and their poop parties. Did you know otters do a little poop dance? To learn even more, scientists collected poop from the latrines each morning. After collecting the poop, they look at it through a microscope to see what kinds of food the otters have been eating. They also send it off to a lab to extract DNA. This DNA can share a lot more information than just an otter's favorite snacks. It can share a whole story about our waterways and ecosystem. Otters are a keystone species, which means they play an important role in our food web and can indicate the health of the habitat. Studying their poop and the parasites found in them provides important health information about the animal and the environment. Looking at this data over long periods of time, we can compare it and see how the ecosystem has changed over the years. Otters in zoos can help this research as well, because we can study their health and compare them to otters in the wild. Wow, that's a great question to explore and answer together. Did you like learning about poop and how it can tell us about animals and the environment? I know I did. Next time you're out exploring nature, keep an eye out for scat and see if you can identify what animals might be in your area just from the scat you see. Remember to always observe scat with your eyes and not with your bare hands. Now, animals that you may find around you, like otters, can tell us a lot about the health of our ecosystems. So keeping our waterways clean is important. Cleaning up trash and picking up after your pets are a few ways to keep our waterways and animals healthy. What will you do to help? I love asking questions and wondering about animals and nature. How about you? Do you have something you're wondering about? Ask a question and go find an answer. You'll be sure to learn a lot of really cool things along the way. Ask an adult to help and they can learn along with you. Thanks for wondering, exploring, and learning with me. I'll see you next time.